Well, hey there, my friends. Thank you for joining me today. I'm Laura Daniels, and this is my channel, Ink and Whimsy, and it's where we come together to write our stories with pictures, paper, and ink. And I'm so glad you've decided to spend a little bit of your day with me. If any of you watched the first video, I am using an oldie but goodie, a wonderful scrapbooking kit from close to my heart, before they close their doors, and it's called Evergreen, and I am using this layout here for my inspiration to tell the story, and this is the second page, of when I went to visit my mom. My mom and I went to visit my brother and sister, who were in a condo up in Conway, New Hampshire, and we went to the Old Village Bakery to buy some cinnamon rolls, and my brother, being a brother, throughout the years would always send photos of him just biting into this yummy cinnamon roll, and the pictures just looked so incredibly delicious to my sister and I. And of course, she's in Washington and I'm in Georgia, so neither one of us were ever able to get these cinnamon rolls until I went home to visit mom, and we went up, well, let's just turn this around, to visit Billy and Donna in the condo. Now, we also went snowshoeing and lots of other fun things, but a highlight was going to get said cinnamon rolls. I want to make sure this is straight. There's nothing like watching a video and it's crooked the entire time, right? All right, so with my inspiration and telling the story, we are going to get this second page all together, and then you guys are going to see the big reveal in the end, and hopefully you're going to think it looks just as lovely all brought together as I do. And I'm going to hold this off to the side because I can't let you see it, can I? And there it is, right there. And I'm going to pause the camera just to make sure I get this right. I had to actually get a ruler because the more I looked at this, the more crooked it looked, and I was just getting all discombobulated looking at the scrapbook page. So, once again, I saved you from myself, and I just put it together. So, this goes about right here. There we go. And then we're going to put down, this right here. This looks real pretty down there. I love how they have all these pieces that just come together so beautifully. So yes, I did get to eat one of those cinnamon rolls, and oh my gosh, I had to take a lot of steps after eating that cinnamon roll, but it was absolutely delicious. It was just so sugary and cinnamony, and oh my goodness. Woo! Yep, it was worth every bite. And I like to joke around and say I flew all the way home to Maine to drive to New Hampshire to get said cinnamon roll. All right, let's put this in the middle. There we go. And now I want to add this same stripe. Now, this is a zip strip. It would come on the ends of your specialty papers from Close to My Heart. Those were the ones that were also in a kit. And if you bought them separately. So these were always the first thing I always cut off, and I'd get excited to say, okay, how am I going to use them? All right, now here's my journaling, and I only had two other pictures. So let's move from the journaling first and mat my two photos. I took this one from outside looking in through the window. So this is one of the photos. Because remember I told you in the first video, the only picture I had of an actual person was my mom and my brother. So they're in the first layout. And then the rest is of the cinnamon roll and the picture of the bakery. And, you know, so I had to spread things out so I could make a two-page layout because it's too many photos for one page, and I really wouldn't be able to tell the story really easily. So I want this photo kind of up here diagonally. I don't want them, you know, perfectly aligned. So I want this one about right here, and I want the journaling that I did. However, there's one thing I want to do to this journaling card is I want to do some smudging on it, or whatever y'all call it, right? So we're going to move these, and I'm going to lay this here, and I want to use some of this toffee ink right here, and I want to get my brush. Let me grab one. I need one that's brown. Not as prepared as I thought I was. And we're going to do like this. And I know y'all have seen this in the videos. You kind of go off to the side and then you come on to the actual card. Because if you lay your brush down right away on the top of the whatever you want to add some color to, you might get a real dark smudge and you didn't mean to do that. So you kind of initially go off the page. And then I think I don't want to do all of it. I kind of want it just to have a little bit of side and then maybe a little bit on this side. All right. Now, do you think I want to do this on the sides? I think that would look good. We're going to do that too. What the heck, right? If it doesn't look good, it doesn't look good. That's it. But I think it looks good. Kind of gives it that old look. Like it's an old menu from a bakery that's been established and around a while. So it kind of adds to the mystique. I love that. That looks good. It's always good when something comes together, especially when you're not quite sure. All right. I think there are some other things I'm going to want to do. Oh, like these right here. Let's just get all this stuff done, shall we? All right. So these two right here, I want to go around the edges. We're going to do that. I think there were a couple of other pieces. Are you just not proud how I am thinking ahead? Huh? All right. Here we go. Because this piece is going to come together pretty quickly. So this one will definitely look good with the darker color on it. It kind of just faded into the beautiful greens and evergreens from before. I'm going to do this one also, which is a little harder because it kind of dips in the middle there. But I think it's working. Okay. I don't want to do all of them. I could go crazy doing every edge. And now, what do I have up here? Was there a piece in all this? Oh, this right here. Definitely want to do this one. Because this just kind of faded into the other ephemera. All right. And then we're going to be able to put this page together. And I'm going to show you the two of them. Which I think it's going to look real pretty all together. Yeah. All right. There you go. Yep. That looks good. So we're going to set this aside right now, unless I think of something else. And we are going to put this together. So let's see, shall we? All right. So I had my cinnamon roll on the bottom. I had the bakery. And I want this like this, like this. Kind of, sorta. All right. And then I want this over here. Kind of get these where I want them. And I think I am going to put these down. And we should start with this one. And just do it in the middle. I'm going to do it about right here. I'm going to go off just a little. Okay. And then this one, I want to come down. And go just a little bit like that. And then we're going to add this. And then this just ran out. So we're going to get, want this on top actually. That looks better, doesn't it? Yes. All right. Now, I have to pause the camera so I can get some more roller tape. Well, I should have showed the process of me trying to figure out how you put the piece inside. I had it every which way. I finally got it together. But that was a good 10 minutes of my day putting that together. usually, you know, when you buy the first one, it's already together, and then you have the spare one, but you see the way the original one is in there, and I did not have that. That was not ready. All right, so wait a minute now. I want to add this in the middle of the doily. I got to get used to this Stampin' Seal. It's a new day because I ran out of my last Close to My Heart roller tape. That was a sad day. All right, now let's do this one. Just a little bit. And with the Stampin' Seal, I got to kind of press it and lift up with it. Otherwise, what happens is the tape continues to come off and it's stuck. All right, so let's put this up here. And I want it on top of that, right there. I want that right there. All right, there we go. All right, and let's put the other doily down. And this one, kind of stuck on there. What do I want on the center of this one? Here we go. Let's do this. You can see a pattern here. And the doilies just look so neat when you think that I am focused on a cinnamon roll bakery shop. The Old Village Bakery. All right, so let's lay this one down. I'm kind of working the Stampin' Seal. This, I want it over here, I think. There we go. Oh, and look at this. This was from the Latte Suite collection with Stampin' Up. So I stamped it, colored it in, because I thought a little coffee cup would just go perfect, right? All right, so let's take this, and I want these up here, and just to have a couple of tags right there. So let's do this first, so I can kind of get this on here, and then we're going to stick this on the gray. See, I'm not used to that. Okay, and we're going to stick this down. All right, so let's do this right here. And let's put these right there. That looks good. And now I wanted a little star because I want to bring out some brown. And this will be perfect. I'm going to put this on there. I like how I added the color on the edges of that, and it gives it a different patina. I guess, is that what that's called? It'd be so funny if that's not the right word. I'm sure somebody will tell me. All right, let's put a few of these down. These green bows. Everygreen. What am I trying to say? It's just evergreen. Is there any other word for it? I thought they were B-O-U-G-H-S. B-O-U-G-H-S. But I could be wrong. I could be wrong. All right, let's stick some of this down. All of this came in the kit. Evergreen. So if any of you were fortunate enough to get your hands on it, I'm sure you just loved putting it together too. I want this right here because we're going to put this circle right over the top of it. We're going to stick this little guy down on there. So let's do this first. I'm going to layer this right here. And then we're going to stick this down. Here we go. All right, put that right in the middle. Oh, that's looking pretty. What do you think? All right, and then we have the coffee cup. And I kind of wanted to put, oh, that looks good. So, first of all, we need to put down some dimensionals. All right, here we go. Whoops. Put that right there. That'll be good. Yeah. All right. So I hope you all have been enjoying your past week. Here we are, out of October, already moving into November. Can you believe it that, you know, I was talking to my hairdresser the other day, and I only see my hairdresser once a month. So that's literally, you know, 12 times out of the year, unless it's maybe 11, because I've done 5 weeks instead of, unless I've done like 11 weeks instead of 12 weeks. And then you think, well, gosh, how things change with what you see of each other. And she had a baby, and every time I see her, the baby's a month older. And, you know, she went from looking pregnant to having the baby to now the baby's 6 months old. And it just shows how fast time goes. Is that not the truth, right? It just goes crazy. So I was thinking about that with how infrequently, you know, I see my hairdresser. And here we are looking at the beginning of November already. Where do I want to put this? Nope. Oh, actually, that kind of looks good right there. I'm going for it. I want that little bit of white showing. All right, so now I want to add, we need to do something with this, the rest of this cluster up here. So remember, we put this together. We're gonna put this down first. I did the edges. And I wanna go right. I'm going off of my, oh, definitely needs to be underneath. And I don't want it exactly matching with that corner, so we're gonna do that. And I wanna put this down. Did y'all ever do it that you're talking with someone, but what you share with them is only half of what you shared that was in your head, the other part you thought, and then you spoke some of it out loud? I kind of feel like I do that a little bit when I'm doing these videos. Like, you're thinking, what did she just say? Well, I thought the first half in my head. I don't know why you don't get what I'm talking about. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the way it goes. I think I want this. Nope, that does not look good. Can we go under here? Nope, we're gonna have to go. I waited too long. Oh, right there, because you can see it better, can't you? Okay, and then we'll stick down some of these evergreens. And we're just gonna pray by the time I'm done that this comes together looking good. All right, we need to stick the other evergreen. Then we may need to, wait a minute, do we need another one down here? I think so, and then we'll put another one up there. Okay, so I want this under here. I'm gonna lift this up, stick that like right there. That looks good. And now I need another evergreen for there. Get a couple. All right, so where do you think? I'm not real happy with this up here. That looks better right there. Just adding that little bit. All right, so here is the end of the story. I had my cinnamon roll and I enjoyed it. So my brother cannot send pictures anymore of him enjoying this wonderful cinnamon roll, and just kind of, you know how brothers will do that. They'll just tease you in your face. That's what they do. All right, so we're going to move things out of the way so that you can see the two of these together. I'm kind of excited. But let's do this first. Let's lift this one up and give you a close-up. There we go. Come on now. All right. Of the different clusters we've did. I love the variation of the browns and the greens, and then you have the outdoor and you have the indoor doilies. And I love how we did the patina on the journaling. And I love how the card, the coffee cup added to the whole thing. All right, so let's lay this down. We're gonna put it right there, and I'm gonna have to stand up a little higher on the stool to see them both together to make sure. Oh, that works. What do you think? I think they look great next to each other. There we go. Oh, you know what? Look at that. Don't look real close because they don't match, but that's okay. They're a little bit off. So there is the drawback to not doing these side by side. So if anyone looks at it that close, you are not my friend. All right, my friends, until we see each other again in YouTube land, God bless. Have an incredible day till we see each other again. Bye-bye.